Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Welcome to my YouTube channel Calculus and Mathematics Learning. In the previous video, we studied and learned the exercise number 3.1 related with variation. That exercise was totally based on direct and inverse relation, inverse variation. Today we are going to start exercise number 3.2, chapter number 3, Variation KPK board. In exercise number 3.2, question number 1 is which of the following quantities? Which one of the following quantities? Which one of the following quantities are in continued proportion? There are three parts in this question. Part 1 is 4, 12, and 16. Part 2 is 3, 12 and 39, and part 3 is 72, 24 and 8. We learned in exercise number 3.1 that what is continued proportion. Let me have a three number A, B, C. So according to the definition of continued proportion, the product of the mean, this is middle number. So the product of the middle number with itself will be equal to the product of the extreme. This is the basic definition of continued proportion. So B square is equal to AC. Using this property in all the three parts of this question number 1. So here the B is the middle number, which is 12. So 12 multiplied 12 will be equal to the product of extreme, which is 16 multiplied 4. So 12 multiplied 12 is equal to 144. And here 16 multiplied 4 gives us 64. Hence the two sides are not equal. It means that 4, 12, 16 are not in continued proportion. Let's check part 2. Using the same property of continued proportion, multiplying the middle number with itself, and here multiply 3 with 39 because these are extreme outside values. 3 multiply 39, 12 multiply 12 gives us 144, and 39 multiply 3 gives us 117. Hence the two sides are not equal. It means that these quantities are not in continued proportion. Checking part 3. Using the same property, so 24 multiply 24 is equal to 72 multiply 8. 24 multiply 24 gives us 576, and 72 multiply 8 gives us 576. As the two sides are equal, it means that these quantities are in continued proportion. Yes, these are in continued proportion. Now move to question number 2. Question number 2 tells that find the mean proportion of 12 and 3. Solution. The two numbers are A and B. So according to the definition of mean proportion, mean means the middle number. This is two numbers, so its middle, let's suppose, is X. Is X so ratio B. So according to the definition of continued proportion, multiplying the middle number with itself is equal to multiplying the extreme A multiply B. So according to the definition, X curve will be equal to AB. Using the same property in the question, the two numbers are 12 and 3. So their middle number, let's suppose, is X. So using the continued proportion property, multiplying the middle with itself is equal to, and multiply the extreme with extreme, so 12 multiply 3. So X square will be equal to 12 multiply 3 gives us 36. So taking under root to the both side, so the value of X will be equal to plus minus under root 36 is 6. So the mean proportion between 12 and 3 is plus minus of 6. So move to question number 3. This question is important in both point of view KPK board. Solving question number 3. If 5:15:x are in continued proportion, find the value of x. Solution. The three number which is 5:15:x are in continued proportion. So according to the basic definition of continued proportion, the product of middle number with itself will always be equal to the product of extreme, which is 5 multiply x. So 15 can be written as 3 multiply 5, and this 15 can be written as 3 multiply 5 is equal to 5x. Divide both sides with 5. So this 5 will cancel out with this 5, and this 5 will cancel out with this 5. So 3 multiply 3 gives us 9, and 9 multiply 5 gives us 45. So the value of x is equal to 45. Now move to question number 4. Question number 4 is same like question number 3. If 3x minus 1, 4 and 35 are in continued proportion. Continued proportion. Find x. Solution. The three numbers are 3x minus 1. This is first number, second is 4, and the last one is 35. Using the property of continued proportion, here the middle number is 4, so multiplying the middle number with itself and multiplying the extreme, which is 3x minus 5 and 5. 4 multiply 4 gives us 16, 3 multiply 5 gives us 15x, and 1 multiply 5 gives us minus 5. Shift minus 5 to the left hand side, so it becomes 16 plus 5 is equal to 15x. So 15x will be equal to 16 plus 5 gives us 21. Divide both sides with 3. So here this side becomes 15 over 3 gives us 5x is equal to 21 divided by 3 gives us 7. Divide both sides with 5. So 5 will cancel out with 5. So we are left with x is equal to 7 over 5. Hence the value of x is 7 divided by 5. Move to question number 5. Question 5 tells that find a mean proportion of a square minus b square and a plus b divided by a minus b. Solution. We solved already a question on mean proportion that if we have a two number like a square minus b square in this case and a plus b over a minus b, this is the so it's mean the middle. So let's suppose the middle of these two numbers are x, a plus b over a minus b. Using the continued proportion property, that multiplying the middle number with itself and multiplying the extreme with itself, so a square minus b square multiplying a plus b over a minus b. X multiply x gives us x square is equal to a square minus b square is the formula, which is equal to a plus b into a minus b, multiplying a plus b divided by a minus b. A minus b is cancelled out with a minus b, so we are left with x square is equal to a plus b and a plus b. Hence the base are same, so their power is 1, so the power will be added. It becomes 1 plus 1 gives us 2. So a plus b whole square. The power on both sides of the equation is same. It means that the base will always be same. So x will be equal to a plus b. So hence the value of x is equal to a plus b. Now move to question number 6. Question number 6 tells that if a by b is equal to c divided by d, then prove that ac plus bd divided by ac minus bd will always be equal to a square plus b square divided by a square minus b square. Solution. Taking the given, which is a over b is equal to c divided by d, we have a property, conferendo and dividendo property. Let's suppose we have a number a over b is equal to c divided by d. So according to the conferendo dividendo property, we have this equation will become a plus b divided by a minus b is equal to c plus d divided by c minus d. This is conferendo dividendo property. Using the same property here, but we multiplying a by b to the both side. Let's suppose, so a by b multiplying a by b to the both side, c divided by d multiplying a by b. A multiply a gives us a square divided by b multiply b gives us b square. A multiply c gives us a c divided by b multiply d gives us b d. Now using this property, a will add with b and denominator a will subtract with b will subtract from a. The same property we use on the right hand side. Using the property adding a square with b square according to the component or divided of property and subtract b square from a square. Applying the same logic on this side, subtract first a bd with ac and denominator subtract bd from ac. So according to the component or dividend of property, we proved that a by b is equal to c by d is equal to a square plus b square, which is a square minus b square is equal to ac plus bd over ac minus bd. Now move to the last question related with exercise number 3.2. There are three parts in question number 7. We are going to solve two parts out of three. Solve equations. This question is also important. Part 1 is under root of 3x plus t plus 2 plus under root of x divided by under root of 3x plus 2 minus under root x is equal to 4 divided by 1. In this question, using the same component or dividend property, let's suppose this under root 3x plus 2 plus under root x is equal to a, let's suppose. And this is, let's suppose, b. Using the same property, a plus b over a minus b. So adding this side with this first term, this side adding with this one, plus under root 3x plus 2 minus under root x. And denominator subtract this side according to the component or dividend property, 3x plus 2 plus under root x. So for subtracting we bring minus and brackets, so under root 3x plus 2 minus under root of x is equal to, using the same property on the left right hand side, so 4 plus 1 in numerator and denominator we are left with 4 minus 1. Here under root x will cancel out with negative under root x, so we are left with 3x plus 2 under root and 3x plus 2 under root, so it becomes 2 times of 3x plus 2 under root divided by under root 3x plus 2 minus under root 3x plus 2 will cancel out, and here we are left with minus minus gives us plus under root x, and under root x it gives us 2 under root of x is equal to, here 4 plus 1 gives us 5 and 4 minus 1 gives us 3. 2 will cancel out with 2. Taking square on both sides, we are going to take 3x plus 2 divided by x in 1 under root according to the property of radicals, divided by x of whole square is equal to 5 divided by 3 whole square. Square will cancel out in the roots. We are left with 3x plus 2 divided by x is equal to 5 square gives us 25 divided by 3 square gives us 9. Now cross multiplication, 9 multiply 3 gives us 27x. 9 multiply 2 gives us 18 is equal to 25 multiply x gives us 25x. So shift 25x to the left hand side, so 27x minus 25x is equal to shift plus 18 to the right hand side becomes minus 18. 27 minus 25 gives us just 2x is equal to minus 18. Divide both sides with 2. So the value of x will be equal to negative 9. So now solving part 2 of this this question number 7. Part 3. Part 3 tells that under root of x square plus a square minus under root of x square minus a square divided by under root of x square plus under root of x square minus a square is equal to 1 divided by 3. Using the component or dividend of property on this side, so let's suppose this is a and this is b, so a plus b. Under root of x square plus a square minus under root of x square minus a square plus o. Let's suppose this is b. So b a square x square plus a square plus under root of x square minus a square divided by this side x square plus a square minus x square minus a square minus o under root of x square plus a square plus under root of x square minus a square is equal to 1 plus 3 gives us 4 and 1 minus 3 gives us minus 2. Minus under root of x square minus a square, we can start with under root x square minus a square. X square plus a square and x square plus a square under root gives us 2 under root a x square plus a square. In numerator and denominator, minus time of under root x square minus a square and minus time of and minus time of under root x square plus x square will cancel out with this side. So we are left with this and this. that gives us minus under root x square minus a square minus, that gives us minus 2 times of under root x square minus a square by a simplifying. 4 divided by minus 2 gives us minus 2. So, cancelling minus with minus on the both sides, 2 will cancel out with 2, taking under root and taking only one radical here, over here. X square plus a square over x square minus a square is equal to taking square both sides, 2 square. Square will cancel out with under root, so we are left with x square plus a square divided by x square minus a square is equal to 2 square gives us 4. Shift to x square minus a square are cross multiplication, so it will multiply with 4. It gives us 4 x square minus 4 a square is equal to 1 multiply x square plus a square gives us x square plus a square. Shift x square to the left hand side becomes 4 x square minus x square, which gives us 3 x square. Shift to minus 4 a square to the right hand side becomes 4 a square plus a square, which gives us 5 a square. Dividing both sides with 3, so we are left with x square is equal to 5 a square divided by 3. Now taking under root for finding the value of x, so x will be equal to plus minus under root of 5 divided by 3, and a square under root can be written as square will cancel out with under root, so we are just left with a. So a will comes from out from the under root, so the value of x in this case is equal to plus minus 5 and divided by 3 under root dot. With this question, this exercise is completed. So guys, subscribe my channel and also hit the bell icon for the latest and upcoming videos of mathematics class 10. Thank you.